guys, what's up? So in today's video, I am talking straight to my first timers out there, my people who are about to attend a music festival for the first time. I was just at Electric Zoo in New York. Had the best time of my life, by the way. It was so, so good. Go watch my vlogs if you guys haven't already. But a lot of the people I met and I talked to, it was their first festival, which was one, so exciting that you guys experienced EZU for the first time and it was your first festival. And two, the fact that you said that it was because you watched some of my videos and I encouraged you to go. Literally the best compliment you could ever give me. I'm so excited that you guys are putting yourselves out there and having new experiences. But anyway, it just made me think, I haven't done a video in a while, a tips video for people who are just about to attend their first festival. I just have a lot of like insider tips. So today that's what it's gonna be. I kind of just wanna talk to you one-on-one, like I'm talking to a friend of mine, and give you guys like the inside scoop of what you can like actually expect to happen at music festivals, especially with me being like fresh off one. I have a lot of advice based on what I just experienced at EZU that I want to incorporate here. And with all of that being said, I am partnered with my friends at The Lunchbox for this video. I'm partnering with them on a couple series to get you guys like really informed and ensure that you guys are having like the best possible festival going experience. So we kind of put our heads together and really thought about the things that we would want you guys to know before you attend a festival for the first time. So these are our thoughts. If you want to know a little bit more about The Lunchbox, I'll link their information down below. Show them some love. I, you know, think that they're doing really, really great things for this community, and I'm so happy to be working with them. So yeah, Lunchbox fam, we love you. But with all that being said, let's get right into the video. So the first thing I want to say is, and it could be that I'm getting older, you guys, I don't know, but music festivals take a toll on your body, like really take a toll on your body. I had upwards of 30,000 steps a day at Electric Zoo, and that's pretty common. I think at EDC Las Vegas, I had almost like 40,000 steps. At the end of each night, I noticed my lower back was hurting. My feet were like, they felt like weights by the end of the night. It takes a toll on your body. Your neck hurts, especially if you're like headbanging, if you're looking up at screens, like it definitely affects your entire body. So just know that going into it. I mean, like if you can stretch, stretch, like our friends and I kind of like took a break and like stretched our quads out a little bit, really get a good night's sleep before the first night and each night. If you can get as many hours in, just know that your body is gonna be hella exhausted after a music festival. Sometimes I book massages. Always after EDC Las Vegas, I book a massage because it just like totally relieves all the tension and the stress in my body. The second thing I wanna say is wear deodorant. This goes for everyone. This is a big thing in this community. People stink. People are really sweaty. There are usually some dudes with their shirts off running around, stinking up the whole place. But no, for real, like at EZU, this definitely happened. It was way hotter than I thought it was gonna be, and I felt like my deodorant like melted off by the end of the day. So definitely wear deodorant. If you guys didn't know, there's this guy, his handle is at Fresh Raver. Go check him out on Instagram. His whole thing is he like brings sticks of deodorant to music festivals, and he's like, he puts deodorant on people. He's super hype. He's put them on a whole bunch of like different artists. It's really, really funny. And I know for Imagine Music Festival, which is coming up, I'm gonna read this. He is doing a deodorant drive, so I wanted to plug him. I don't even know him. We've never met. Like just from Instagram, I knew he was doing this, and I want to like help support. So I'm spreading the word. He posted, I'm partnering up with at EDM Cares for an official drive at Imagine Music Festival. We're collecting deodorant, other hygiene products, as well as clothes for the homeless. Our goal for Imagine is to collect 1,000 sticks of deodorant and 5,000 clothing items. So if you are going, definitely bring a stick of deodorant, a piece of clothing. Like I definitely have to go out and buy that because I want to bring it with me and I don't want to forget. So just wanted to plug that. But the main point of all that being, wear deodorant, it's gonna be stinky. Next thing I wanna mention, I would expect to not have good cell service. Now this depends on the festival. A lot of festivals will like claim that they're working with different partners and they're trying to bring you better cell service, but it completely depends. EDC Las Vegas is notorious for like, I never have cell service there, maybe every now and then. However, at Electric Zoo this past weekend, everyone was saying like I had perfect service. I could text the whole weekend. It was absolutely no problem. It just completely depends. You know, pick meetup spots with your friends, sort of coordinate what sort of sets you want to go to, and just go into it thinking that you will not have cell service. The next tip is use medics and ground control to your advantage, you guys. So if you didn't know this going into it, obviously there's always gonna be medical staff at festivals, but typically most festivals have a ground control, which is people that they usually wear some sort of uniform or shirt and they all match. It's usually like a like bright color. And they basically like go around checking to make sure that people are okay. If people are sitting on the ground or taking a nap, they'll go and shake them and make sure that everything's fine. They'll go around knocking on porta potty bathrooms to make sure that no one's passed out in there. So if you see those people walking around, they're there to help you. And just be forewarned that almost every music festival has that sort of staffing on hand. So go to them if you need anything. Okay, this next point, this one hits home, because it was a real problem for me at Izu. Expect for water refill station lines to be very long. Now, if the festival does a good job of this, they will have multiple water refill stations. They're always free, and you know, it should be like rocking and rolling pretty quick. Some of them will have attendants who actually like do the jets and they like fill up the water for you. I think that's super helpful because it just makes everything go much faster. Always fill up your hydration pack as soon as you get to the festival so you at least have something on hand to go. One other thing is when you're online, this is just a tip for anybody, especially you guys who are beginners, open your hydration pack before you get up there so you're prepared. I love the Lunchbox hydration pack because they have an easy like water refill system. It's not like a Camelback where you're sitting there screwing things on, because I always had an issue with that. You literally just like slide it around and it's a pouch that you open up. It's the easiest thing ever. Anyway, with that, I'm like quick and easy and done and out the door, but a lot of people will like hold up the line because they'll fill up their water and then they'll try and like screw on their Camelback or whatever they have, and it just like takes forever. So fill your thing up and then move to the side and then close your water on the side so that people can just like keep it moving. Okay, the next one. I feel like this is a given, but the porta potties get disgusting, like really disgusting at the end of the night. I always bring wet wipes. I've said this a million times, just to like wipe my hands. A lot of the music festivals will have pump sinks, so you like pump the water and you can like wash your hands, but sometimes they run out of water. Sometimes they run out of paper towels. The bathrooms are run out of toilet paper. You don't even, like when it gets dark at night and you can't see anything, not a good situation. So just be forewarned, the bathrooms get really, really disgusting at some point. And I've told this story before, I'll put a card up in here. I've gotten lost at music festivals before at the porta potties, because usually, guys, it's one of the most chaotic areas if you've never been before. Again, it's really dark. Sometimes the lighting in that area isn't that good. There's so many people going in and out. All the porta potties look the same, especially if like you're drinking or you're like under some sort of substance or something. It can get confusing. My friends and I will usually go one for one. Like I'll hold their stuff while they go into the porta potty so they don't have to put it on the ground or like anything gross, and then we'll switch. This past weekend at Electric Zoo, it was so chaotic that my boyfriend and I went into one of the like bigger porta potties that fit multiple people. So we went in together. Anyway, you could do that as well. Okay, so you'll know this going into it if you check the weather, but it can get really cold at night depending on where the festival is. A lot of you guys who camp probably know this, but I typically pack layers with me. So I'll throw like a kimono in, or a sweatshirt, or a jacket, or like a top that's long sleeve. I just did that for Izu. I brought my like long sleeve mesh Tasteful Girls top that was so cute, and I threw that on during the last set at Izu, and I just felt like more covered when I was walking home going to the Uber. So you can bring layers, pack in your hydration pack some layers if you guys typically get cold. The next thing, okay, so this is a big one. It seems obvious, but even I messed this up at Izu. Have like a snack schedule and an eating schedule. So 1000% eat a big meal beforehand, because one, it's expensive at music festivals, and two, you're gonna like need the energy to be like dancing and moving around all night. I made the fatal mistake at Izu on Friday. We drank way more than we ate, and I ended up only having, I think, 3 mozzarella sticks the entire day. And it's not because I, like, for any reason in particular, we just were busy. We were at sets, we were dancing, we were having fun. The time flies by, and we left the festival, and I felt absolutely horrible. Horrible, I had a pounding headache, and then I realized I had only eaten 3 mozzarella sticks the entire day. So, and that's somebody who's gone to music festivals for like years and years. So have a snack schedule, you guys. Take breaks, sit down. Eat a big meal beforehand. You just like really need the energy to keep going throughout the night, you know, and like alcohol is not a substitution for a meal. So definitely please eat something. Okay, the next one. It's almost always a mess leaving festivals, especially if you wait for like the last set to end and then you're out the door. Definitely do your research on transportation options beforehand. Don't be the people who are like, oh, we're gonna Uber home and like not even think about it and just wing it. Don't do that, especially if you're like at a music festival that's like on a much larger scale, like an Ultra or a Coachella or like whatever it is. Research your transportation options. There's almost always shuttles that they offer, ride share. So definitely research beforehand. There can be crazy surging prices when that many people are leaving a festival at once. Again, you might not have cell service. So just do yourselves a favor, guys. go on the festival website. They almost always have like a travel in the navigation. Click on that and what they suggest getting home. It's almost always like public transportation of some sort. At least in the tri-state area it is. Okay, another thing. There are a lot of undercover cops. A lot of undercover cops. So just be very forewarned in the crowd. Don't take anything from strangers. Don't, like, if people come up to you asking you if you have stuff, don't be stupid. Don't sell anything to anybody. There are so many undercover cops at shows nowadays, so just like be careful. Okay, next point is a fun one. You're gonna see a lot of body parts, you guys. You're gonna see a lot of body parts. People like to dress pretty, scandalous, skimpy, whatever. It's a total freedom of expression. Everybody can wear whatever they want, you know, whatever makes you comfortable, whatever floats your boat. It's that kind of mentality, especially like in a rave culture. Shout out to my podcast. It's like a no judgment zone. So know that going into it, you might just be like totally caught off guard if you've never been around a crowd like that before, but that can definitely happen. So expect to see a lot of people in like extravagant outfits, costumes, little to no clothing, you know. You'll probably get used to it after the first hour. And another point I kind of want to make about that while I'm on this topic, everybody has a story. There are so many different people from like all walks of life, age ranges, like backgrounds, musical interests. Don't be afraid to talk to people, meet new people, go out of your comfort zone. I know a lot of the times at your first festival, like you might feel very comforted in being with like your friends and the people that you know, especially if you're more like shy or introverted, but music festivals are like one of the best opportunities to meet new people. And you guys clearly already have common interests, so it's just such a cool, like open, welcoming type of vibe at most of them. And I just really enjoy talking to people and interacting with people, and it's so easy. Like, you're all in the crowd dancing, like hanging out. Just know that everyone there has a story, and just try and be like respectful and kind to the people around you. Another point, you don't need to know how to dance or how to shuffle to have a good time, especially if you're like self-conscious about dancing. Don't worry about it. Seriously, like, no one's really paying attention to you. Everyone's paying attention to the show. There are also usually so many shuffle circles and like shuffle groups going around. You can ask somebody to show you how to do a move or ask somebody to teach you really quickly, you know. Just put yourself out there. So definitely don't feel like you need to know how to dance to attend a music festival. Last two things. This might seem obvious, but music festivals have garbage cans. I didn't know if a lot of people knew that. The ground is not a place to just throw your shit, and one of the most common things you'll see, which like might take you by surprise, is the amount of trash that gathers on the floors, you guys. It's really bad. People like just in the middle of the floor will drop their Gatorade bottles, their water bottles, like whatever. Really commonly you'll find yourself tripping or stepping or kicking bottles like around you. It's crazy how much garbage is on the floor, especially when you're walking around. People just leave their trash everywhere, and it's really bad. So try and not litter. Try and throw your stuff out if you can. Hold it, put it in your bag, and throw it out when you're out of the crowd. And lastly, your phone will drain really quickly, especially if you're like filming a lot. Like for me, it's different. I know a lot of people say like put your phone away and like just enjoy the moment. I totally hear that, but for people like us who are content creators, like I'm on my phone a lot. I'm creating Instagram stories and snapping people. Bring an external charger if you guys can. I brought one into Electric Zoo and into EDC Las Vegas just to have it. I didn't even use it all of the nights, but it was good to have it just to give me some extra juice. I also used to have a Mophie charger, so just recommending that. And then the Lunchbox hydration pack, which what I love about it is there's a pouch in it for external chargers, and then you can like run the wire through it to plug in your phone. So some hydration packs come with those like pockets already built into them. Anyway, you guys, that's everything you should know and what you can expect before you attend your first music festival. I hope that gives you guys just like a better idea of like what's gonna happen. This is the reality of what it is. So thank you guys to the Lunchbox team for partnering with me on this video. I hope to see you guys all at a music festival very soon. Enjoy your first experience. Please leave me a comment down below. What are you doing? Like, what is your first show? What festival is it that's gonna be your first experience? I can't wait to hear about it. Please give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Feel free to subscribe, click the bell so you're notified every time I post. And yeah, go show the Lunchbox some love. All their information will be down below. I think that's it, you guys. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye, guys.